Peri Mwingi, Ibani Jadit, Pascal, Etie Pinka Kecha Karawange Peri, Tiwe Etie La Nyup Mimar, Don Kaikelu, Ibinyu Tumar Peri, Nijapuskopi Kode, Tiwe Pende Nyup Mia, Kwa Mwana, Manen, Mamil Chal Ature Eni, Belu Ngoma Eni, Ikare Moku Belu Gopi Naka. Don Pilende Maeni, Wabela Kwayo, Wanu Wajumini Di Catholic Diocese, Ni Atiwe Ni Gibiri, Tiwe Ma Eni Ma Mungu Chuyu, Ma Ini Jako Kodipo Tumoko, Ungo Kodi Tiwe Moku, Madame Don Kawuni, Chuyu Ku Karatasi Gi Kwa Ngogino. Yen inyutu go la nyutu mania kwa mwae beru pikare mano do wakwa yunia eberi tiwe maandani ya inye ni domuku echukume nyutu mia kwa mwae ni kwa rinang eberi lengi ukani kakara ne romo ebine mana ebito kaiti kutiwe ne muku majuku chuku karatasi no ibigu wako kon inye misa wabiti ukugipi lande mukende wafoyo chire wafoyo ile pimara na eni muku nangi keipi chanyeshi ninyo go So during the mass, normally there are certain parts of the mass that are sung, and so we are going to sing them together. If the deacon intones, then we have to respond as the faithful. So we begin. At the time of the gospel, the deacon might tell us,
the Lord be with you.
Then we respond,
and with your spirit.
So try together,
the Lord be with you.
The Lord be with you. Again,
the Lord be with you.
Then he might continue.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Try that again.
Glory to you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you.
So the words are glory to you, O Lord.
Glory to you. Jesus Christ who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
Caracello.
Amen. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
At the end of the Mass, the deacon might sing for us in Latin. KD. Then, while Gamma Paracello, we shall respond.
gracias mía, lo fue mongo. Thanks be to God, while for a drone. So I tell him, Caracello,
of us who are here because of the nature of the weather in the event that you feel naturally inconvenienced within yourself, we have places of convenience at the media center. You can move there. The people in charge of security will direct you accordingly, depending on how you explain yourself according to the nature of the inconvenience you feel within yourself. Within here, we have some places under those eucalyptus trees. They can also help you to sort yourself out. Yes. Abe Wachunia, Landopa Kumkenwang near Kumi the Benji, Landamoko, Magibegi Banjo Komono, Watiku Kabedumoko, Te Kalafuru Chagicha, Aneno Dano Moko. Yube kwa alere gibe shiduwecha. Ka inu ingiri kumecha, ichidi kakecha. Watie ku kabedwe ni gimoku, your media sender. Ka ichidi kakecha, askarde bikonyi niya ichidi otinema cha, kunuma no, kitima nyutire mani nyutu pekuperi. Kude igi kakecha. Ejo ruwa dresi, ruwa ka lemi tipe pariazia, ruwa mejose ani, angwazi patime tioda, ane bazi ugurumuzu wa lene adaleda, mivini mecho minze, ejerera, adesukuni muta ndedelere, ere onyeruri ya, balo ni muzu isiri ya, balo aloni muzu isiri ka. Kaniku, mecho vini mu angwazi banumve media senda roda maalia dara, askari idachi, ejo nde media mami ruo dale ngone yari, milo eini da, yani mu echemini imungole afa miruani lemi majeri jezu ani beniru. Sawe mavuti ya madie misedora, amaovu ngonde. Wadu fuo eritasi. Kwaya.
Let us all prepare to begin the Mass. The procession is about to begin, so we ask the choir to begin for us the entrance song. Thank you.
symbols. We have the symbol of the cross, the Bible, the Word of God, the chalice and the bowl.
And of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
May we be seated for a while. Shall have for now the reading of the biography, and I invite the Vicar General to do that for us. Thank you.
Your Grace, the main celebrant, and fellow mourners, allow me, on behalf of the Bishop Ordinary, the Right Reverend Raphael Pumon Wakurach, and on behalf of maybe Catholic Diocese, and on behalf of the whole Catholic Church, let me say, on behalf of the whole humanity, to read for you the biography of the late
Right Reverend Martin Luluga, Bishop Emeritus of Nebi Catholic Diocese. Bishop Emeritus Martin Luluga was born on March 1st, 1933 at Ludonga, Arua Diocese, to Mr. Mzee Mark Lea and Mama Isolina Asendra. He was the second child in a family of 3 sons and 6 daughters. He was baptized on March 5th, 1933, and received his first Holy Communion on January 3rd, 1943, and his confirmation on March 28th, 1943. His early education. He attended Ludonga Primary School for his primary level and La Shaw Seminary for his secondary, philosophical and theological studies. His priestly life. He was ordained priest on June 1st, 1963 at Ludonga Minor Basilica by Bishop Angelo Tarantino, the Bishop of Arua by then. His first assignment was to Olepi Parish as a curate. And for about 6 months, when he stayed there at Olepi Parish, later he was transferred to Lugiri Parish. In 1969, he was sent to Rome at the International Center for Pastoral Theology, and he obtained a diploma in social sciences. And at Father Lombard Center for a Better World for Diplomatic Relations. From studies, when he came back to the Diocese of Arua, he was appointed Basa at St. Peter and Paul Pokea Minor Seminary, Arua. On May 7, 1972, he was appointed Vicar General of Arua Diocese and given the title Monsignor, and he continued to work as Basa for Pokea Minor Seminary. Between 1979 and 1983, they moved to Congo because of war with some priests, religious sisters, and Christians of Arua Diocese. There, he attended to their pastoral, spiritual, as well as some of their material needs. You could say he was in charge of the community that moved to Congo because of war. In 1983, when they returned to Uganda from Congo, Monsignor Martin Luluga was posted to Uganda Matters National Seminary, Alakulum in Gulu, and was appointed by Uganda Episcopal Conference as the General Spiritual Director and a lecturer of spiritual theology. In 1986, he was called back to Arua Diocese by his bishop and appointed as the diocesan treasurer. His episcopate. On October 17th, 1986, he was elected by Pope John Paul II as the auxiliary bishop of Gulu Diocese and the titular bishop of Akwe in Dacia. On January 11, 1987, he was ordained bishop in Gulu Cathedral Church. The Right Reverend Cipriano Biahima Kiangire, the then bishop of Gulu Diocese, was the principal consecrating bishop, and the Right Reverend Cesera Asili, the then bishop of Lira Diocese, and the Right Reverend Frederick Dandua, the then bishop of Arua, were the co-consecrating bishops. In 1988, Pope John Paul II appointed Bishop Martin Luluga the apostolic administrator of Gulu Diocese. On February 8, 1990, John Paul II appointed him the Bishop Ordinary of Gulu Diocese and was installed on April 12, 1990. On January 2, 1991, John Paul II appointed Bishop Martin Luluga the Bishop Ordinary of Nebi Diocese and was installed on April 1999. On February 8, 2011, Bishop Martin Luluga retired being the Bishop Ordinary of Nebi Diocese and opted to have his own residence to live in. On Saturday, July 30th, 2022, this year, last month, at about 9:20 a.m., Bishop Emeritus Martin Luluga was called by the Lord from this earthly vessel. May the good Lord rest his soul in eternal peace. Amen. His sickness. In 2015, Bishop Emeritus Martin Luluga was diagnosed with a terminal heart problem, high blood pressure or hypertension at Uganda Heart Institute Mulago Hospital and recommended by the doctor for a permanent pacemaker. The diocese had to order this machine for him from South Africa. On July 15, 2016, a permanent pacemaker implantation was done to aid his heart. The machine is still weak up to now. From this date on, Bishop Martin had monthly medical reviews in the same hospital, Mulago, accompanied by Reverend Father Aloysius Orion, who was assigned when he was still a deacon to attend to Bishop Martin Luluga and his driver, David Jashan. In April 2022, Bishop Martin began experiencing swelling on his feet, but could move with it. Even he attended some religious functions like Christmas on April 13, 2022. He also attended all sessions of Episcopal Conference in June this year. He was present when Ofaka Parish, a new parish, was opened on June 25th, 2022. However, early July 2022, big winds rapidly developed, especially from his heels, covering the whole of his feet, especially the right foot, while the left leg had some dark dotted scars like spots. On Thursday, July 20th, 22, Bishop Martin was taken to Mulago Hospital, accompanied by Father Luis Surian and his driver. On Friday, July 22nd, 2022, and Monday, July 25th, 2022, thorough checkups were done on him. He was diagnosed with kidney failure and given treatment for a week. Then he would return for review. On Tuesday, July 25th, 2022, they came back to the diocese, and immediately his caretaker, Father Alois Surian, reported to us about the condition of the Bishop Emeritus. On Friday, July 29th, 2022, around 10 minutes past 8, the Vicar General visited the Bishop. The Bishop was quite sober, except he was experiencing severe pain on the right leg where the wounds were much. The Vicar General anointed him and gave him Holy Communion and suggested to him to be taken to Angal Hospital that day. But the Bishop told the Vicar General he would discuss about this the next day. In the evening around 8 p.m., the Vicar General and the Chancellor and a team of medical doctors from Nebi Hospital came to check on the Bishop and found he was resting after his supper and his drugs. They did not wake him up. However, shortly after these people had left Bishop's residence, a team of medical personnel from Angal Hospital also came to check on him. On Saturday, July 30th, 2022, around 8:12 a.m., the Vicar General and a team of two medical personnel from Nebi Hospital again went to check on the Bishop. As they were on the way, the caretaker, his cook, the cook of the Bishop, called the Vicar General, informing him about the deteriorating conditions of the Bishop. On arrival, the Vicar General went to give him Holy Communion, but found him unconscious. His driver, who was with him, tried to call him, but could not respond. Then the medical personnel entered to check on him. At 9:20 a.m., the medical personnel led by Dr. Jonathan declared to us that the Bishop Emeritus was no longer breathing. We then went in and commended him to the Lord. We requested the medical personnel to prepare him for further management. They prepared him and took him for further investigations. They confirmed that Bishop Emeritus died of multiple organs failure. Appreciations. As a diocese, we cannot do much more than we did to save Bishop's life nor can we remain silent without saying a big thank you. First and foremost, to God for the life, gift, and work of Bishop Emeritus Martin Luluga to the Catholic Diocese for 12 solid years, from 1999 to 2011. Secondly, to Bishop Emeritus Luluga, Martin Luluga himself, for diligently executing his vocation as a good shepherd with the motto, God is love. He has run his race to the finish, tended the flock entrusted to him with love, gentleness, and peace. He was a visionary leader, a role model, wise administrator, dedicated and committed chief pastor who served God with love and humanity with great care, fidelity, compassion, generosity, and focus. He was a man of development, the cathedral, administration block, centenary bank, maybe branch, and many other projects speak loudly without much say about Bishop Martin Luluga. He had special concern for priests' health, conducive presbyteries, and churches. He was a man of nature and field work. Trees around our bishop residence down there and around the cathedral are his work. This ceremonial ground used to be his maize field. Thank you, Papa Bishop Martin. Thirdly, to the medical teams of Uganda Heart Institute, Mulago, especially Dr. Amandua Jacinto, I hear is around. Yes, he's down there. We thank Nurse Sylvia and Jane Francis Munduro, with whom you are working on Bishop from before the implant of the pacemaker up to July 25th, 2022, when the Bishop went for review and when you told him to come home for a week. We are also very grateful to the medical team of Nebi Hospital, led by Dr. Jonathan, who was the one who declared to us that the bishop had his last breath. Jonathan, I think, is around also. Then we have Mr. Xavier Weir, who was working closely with Dr. Jonathan. We are grateful to Administrator Peace and Mr. Ozea, the in charge of the last room, the in charge of mortuary, for the latest care and management on the late Bishop Emeritus. We are also grateful to the medical team of Anal Hospital for checking on the bishop on his sick bed. Fourthly, and in a very special way, we would like to extend our appreciation to Father Aloysius Orion, who took care of the bishop till his last days, to his driver, David Joshan, who was with the bishop always, to his cook, Bosco Apango, to Sister Catherine Akidi of the Little Sisters of Mary Immaculate of Gulu. We are grateful to Honorable Mavengina Kunu Catherine. Whenever the bishop went for a view, Catherine Mavengina would shake on him. And Mr. John Kayompo and family, who took bishop as their child and often helping him. A very big thank you to His Grace John Baptist Odama for his personally spending much of your time and energy giving us direction on what to do when we lost our dear bishop. We are grateful to your lordships Sabino Odoki and Santos Lino Wanok, who, learning of the demise of Bishop Emeritus, personally were completely in touch with us. We thank you, Bishop Santo Lino Wanok, for the pacemaker you bought for our Bishop Martin when he was discovered with heart failure. Thank you to the Uganda Episcopal Conference for all the support, moral, financial, spiritual, material you accorded to Bishop Martin and to Nebi Catholic Diocese when our bishop especially was not in the country. A big thank you to the siblings, relatives, friends, and all those who supported Bishop Martin in one way or the other. Last but not least, to the Diocesan Authority who provided for his upkeep after his retirement and for his treatment. And to all of you who have come to share with us in the life of Bishop Martin as we stand in of today, thank you. We continue to say thank you very much. We appreciate you. We thank you for showing solidarity with us. May God bless you. Bishop Martin enjoyed personal readings and telling stories and followed events of times both within and outside the diocese. He was a man of his time. He loved nature, land. Most of our land have title because of the bishop. He was a man interested in gardening, tree planting, and flowers. He loved the education of the young, and he loved ongoing formation of priests and educated many people as well. He spent much of his time with people, and more especially the elderly. He was a promoter of vocations in all aspects. He had a lot that speak about him. Our prayer for him is, may the good Lord, whom he served for all his life, rest his soul in eternal peace.
May we now rise up as to continue with the Mass.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge that we are sinful people and accept God's mercy to have an effect on us by confessing. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, my words, in what I have done, what I have failed to do, through my fault,
through my most grievous fault.
Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O God, who chose the servant bishop Martin Luluga from among your priests and endowed him with pontifical dignity in the apostolic priesthood, grant, we pray, that he may also be admitted to their company forever. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the righteous are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed in the view of the foolish to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction, but they are in peace. For if to others indeed they seem punished, yet in their hope full of immortality, chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the finals, he proved them, and as a sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. In the time of their judgment, they shall shine and dart about sparks through stubble. They shall judge nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord shall be their king forever. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love. Because of grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with the elect. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. For I am already being poured out like a libation, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have competed well. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. From now on, the crown of righteousness awaits me, which the Lord, the just judge, will award to me on that day. And now only to me, but to all who have longed for his appearance. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. that time, seeing the crowds, Jesus went up on the mountain. And when he sat down, his disciples came to him. And he opened his mouth and taught them, saying,